Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a professional copy editor who shares writing tips for the real world on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. This tutorial demonstrates how to use the spelling and grammar check in Microsoft Word 2016 running on Windows. Word spelling and grammar check is one of the simplest, yet most important tools in the Office suite. The interface for this critical tool evolves with each version of the software and has experienced substantial change in recent versions. You can run the spelling and grammar check with grammar and spelling, or just with spelling. So let's begin by looking at how to include or exclude grammar. First, select the File tab. Then select Options in the Backstage view. Now select Proofing in the Word Options dialog box. And then select or deselect Check Grammar with Spelling. Lastly, select the OK button to save your selection and close the Word Options dialog box. After you have decided whether to include or exclude grammar, you can run the spelling and grammar check. Begin by selecting the Review tab, and then select Spelling and Grammar. The editor will appear on the right side of the screen. For spelling errors, you can choose an option from the suggestion list to change that instance of the spelling error. Or, open the drop-down menu for a suggestion and select Change All to change every instance of that spelling error to the suggestion. You can also choose Add to Dictionary to add the word with its current spelling to your custom dictionary, Ignore Once to ignore that instance of the spelling error, or Ignore All to ignore every instance of the spelling error. Occasionally, Word won't be able to provide any suggestions. However, when that lapse occurs, the software will still offer the opportunity to add the word to your custom dictionary, ignore the word once, or ignore every instance of the word. If the software detects a grammar error, you can choose an option from the suggestions list to change that instance of the error. Or select Ignore Once to ignore that instance of the error, Don't check for this issue to stop checking for that type of grammar error in the document, or Options for Clarity and Conciseness to open the Grammar Settings dialog box where you can customize your grammar check. If you want to learn about the grammar error and see examples, open the drop-down menu above the text box. If you decide to make an edit in the text while the spelling and grammar check is running, it will automatically pause itself. Select the Resume button when you're ready to restart the check. If you have chosen to include readability statistics in your proofing options, the Readability Statistics dialog box will appear after you complete the spelling and grammar check. For more basic tutorials on Microsoft Word, please see my Word playlist linked below. You can find this tutorial in written format on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if you have a question about Microsoft Word or Adobe Acrobat that you'd like me to address in a future video. And please subscribe and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.